I'll explain you how to solve the problems on steam formation. For solving the problems on steam formation, these are all the simple formulas. In this, the particulars, enthalpy, internal energy, specific volume, density. For these particulars, I have given the formulas in this. So to solve any problems, first you must decide, you must check which type of steam it is, whether it is wet steam, dry steam, or superheated steam. That you must check first. In the problem, either they may mention that whether it is wet steam, dry steam, or superheated steam, or in few problems you will have to check before you solve the problem. So if it is a wet steam, these are all the formulas. If it is a dry steam, and these are all the formulas. Same way, if it is superheated steam, corresponding formulas are given here. So for enthalpy, it is HI is equal to CPW into TI minus 273. This formula is applicable only if they give you initial temperature. If they don't give initial temperature, in such cases, you do not have to take this. You can only refer to this formula. This formula itself is your final answer. Whatever the answer you get from by using this formula, that is the final answer to get the enthalpy. In case if the initial temperature they are given, then you'll have to use this as a first step, then the second step, then the third step. And finally, if you use this or if you use this, you will get the enthalpy in kilojoule per kg. If they give you the mass, then you will have to use this such that you can convert this kilojoule per kg into kilojoule. Same way, the similar formulas I have given here. If it is dry steam, again, in case if they give you initial temperature, in such cases, you take this formula, or else this formula is not required. And if you know that it is a dry steam, HG value you'll have to find out. That is the final answer for enthalpy. That you can directly get it from the steam table. You don't have to use the formula. There is a formula to find out this HG also, but not required. Directly you can get it from the steam table. Same way, if it is superheated steam, again, initial enthalpy they are given. To find out the initial enthalpy, the formula they are given, but this is applicable only in case if they are given the initial temperature. This is, again, the superheated enthalpy. Since you know that it is a superheated steam, you should use the formula for superheated enthalpy. Okay. Then again, this formula is applicable only, again, if they are given the initial temperature. If you find out this only, this is applicable, or else this itself is the final answer. Similarly, internal energy, this is a formula, UW is equal to enthalpy minus pressure into specific volume. Again, this UW is in kilojoule per kg. The unit of this is kilojoule per kg. To find out if they are given the mass value, then you should use this and you should get in kilojoule. Similarly, this formula is similar for dry steam and superheated steam. Only thing is you should take the corresponding value of superheated steam. Same way, if it is specific volume, if it is wet steam, this is the formula. VW is equal to X into VG. X is dryness fraction. VG is the specific volume of dry steam. This again, you can get it directly from the steam table. If you know that it is a dry steam, you can directly get it from the steam table. That itself is a specific volume. Similarly, to find out superheated steam specific volume, then you will have to use this formula. The ratio between the specific volume and temperature, and the corresponding ratio between the specific volume and the temperature for dry steam. By that, you just need this specific volume of superheated steam. So by using this formula, just keep this here, and the temperature of superheated steam, you can take it to the other side. That way, you will get this formula. Same way, density. Density, we know it is a reciprocal of specific volume. So that is what I have written here. 1 by VW, 1 by VG, 1 by V superheated. These are the formulas you will have to refer. Now, in the last lecture, I have already given the formula for dryness fraction. So here it is MW. the water the mass of the water particles and the mass of the dry steam. Okay. So in this question, they ask for dryness fraction. Determine the dryness fraction of steam if 0.8 kg of water is in suspension with 45 kg of dry steam. So directly they have mentioned that 0.8 kg of water particles are there. 45 kg of dry steam is there. Right now, this 45 kg of dry steam is nothing but mg. Mg is nothing but mass of the dry steam. So 45 kg of dry steam. So mg is 45. I have substituted here. Similarly, 0.8 kg of water particle they are given, that is mw. So in place of mw, I have written 0.8. Again mg, that is 45. So by calculating this, you will get this 0.9825. This is the value of dryness fraction. So in this problem, they didn't ask you wetness fraction. What is wetness fraction? 1 minus x. If you substitute this value in this x value, you will get y value. That is a wetness fraction. Of course, in this problem, they not ask you. If they ask you also, you just find out wetness fraction by using this formula, 1 minus x. Okay, this is just a simple problem. So moving on to next problem. In the next problem, they are given, they asked for how much heat is needed to convert 1 kg. That means they are given the mass of 1 kg of feed water at 20 degrees Celsius. They are given the temperature, initial temperature, they are given 20 degrees Celsius. So what I mentioned, if they give you initial temperature, then this formula HI in the wet steam, dry steam or super dry steam, you have to use this formula if they have mentioned initial temperature. So in this case, they are given initial temperature. That means you have to follow the steps. First, you need to calculate HI, initial enthalpy. And they are given, it is converted into dry saturated steam. That means the type of steam is dry steam because it is converted from 20 degrees Celsius. The water is converted to dry saturated steam. Now you got to know it is a dry steam. So that is how you must decide first which type of steam it is. Based on the particular type of steam, we have given the formulas there. Use those formulas and just solve it. Now, according to this, I got to know that it is a dry steam. So use the dry steam formulas. At what pressure? It is 10 bar. 10 bar they are given. Take the specific heat of water as 4.187 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So since they are given 20 degrees Celsius, I'll use the HI value. I'll follow that step. So in the dry saturated steam column, I'll use the formulas. So you need to find out enthalpy. First, I'll take HI is equal to CPW into TI minus 273. So in this case, first I found out HI. The first step is HI. HI is equal to CPW into TI minus 273. What is TI? The initial temperature. Initial temperature is how much? 20 degrees Celsius. I'll convert this into Kelvin. Whenever you have a temperature, you convert that into Kelvin. Whenever you are substituting in formulas, you convert that into Kelvin and just substitute. So they are given the initial temperature as 20 degrees Celsius. I convert it to Kelvin, then it becomes 293 minus 273. What is CPW? Specific heat of water. CPW, specific heat of water. That is 4.187 they are given. That way I got HI. Fine. Now, first step is over. Again, the second step, HG you have to get from the steam table. So what you need to do, you should refer into steam table. From the steam table, since they are given the pressure here, you should refer into the pressure based table. Okay, there are two tables in it, in the steam table. One is based on the pressure, one is based on the temperature. If they are given the pressure, you refer to pressure based table. If they are given the temperature, you refer to temperature based table. So in this case, they are given 10 bar, that is pressure they are given. So for 10 bar, these are all the values you get in the steam table. One is saturation temperature, that is equal to 179.9 degrees Celsius, that is available in the steam table. Again, enthalpy of saturated water, that is HF. HF is equal to 762.6. Even this is available in the steam table. HFG, that is 2013.6. Again, this is available in the steam table. HG also available in the steam table. All these four values are available in the steam table itself. Okay, just refer into the steam table. You copy the values in it. Okay, it is 10 bar diagram. So pressure based steam table, you should, pressure based table you refer, you get all these values, all the four values. Okay, now what is the second step? The second step is HG, that is from the steam table. So HG is equal to how much? Whatever I get from the steam table, that is 2776.2, that value I have directly substituted here. That itself is a HG value. What is the third step? Third step is small h is equal to HG minus HI. So that is plus. The third step, H is equal to HG minus HI. HG I know, HI I found it here. That value I substitute here. Finally, I got this. This is the H value. Okay, what is the final step? Capital H, because that is in kilojoule per kg. Capital H is equal to, you are multiplying by mass, so kg, kg get cancelled, remaining is only kilojoule. So mass into H. Mass is 1 kg they are given. H, you have got it here. This value you substitute. And finally, you get capital H. That's all. That is the second problem. Moving on to next problem. Here they ask for, find the enthalpy. Again, you are finding out the enthalpy. Find the enthalpy of 1 kg mass, 1 kg they are given. Again, they are given the pressure of 12 bar. That means you should refer to pressure based steam table. When, for first question, steam is 22% wet. So according to this first question, the steam is wet steam. In the second question, the steam is dry saturated. So according to this, the steam is dry steam. The type of steam is dry steam. So for this, you refer to wet steam table. For this, you refer to dry steam formula table. Again, the last question, superheated to 250 degrees Celsius. For this, you refer to superheated column. Assume the specific heat of superheated steam is 2.25 kJ per kg. Remember, the specific heat of water is different than the specific heat of superheated steam is different. Okay. CPW is a specific heat of water. CPS is a specific heat of steam. So solving the problem, they are given the mass as 1 kg, pressure as 12 bar. So from the steam table at pressure 12 bar, I'll get all these values. All the values, all these values are available in the steam table. Just copy it and write it here. Then solving the first problem. For the first question, enthalpy of wet steam. Since they are given it is 22% wet, it means that it is a wet steam. So they are given 22% wet. That means it is a wetness fraction. It's not a dryness fraction. Fine. So Y is equal to 22%. If Y is equal to 22%, what is X? 100 minus 22, that is 78. But I need in fraction, that is 0.78. That is a dryness fraction. So since you've got to know that it is an enthalpy of wet steam, I'll refer to wet steam formulas. And you should remember that they are not given any initial temperature in this. In such cases, what I need to do, this I should not use. So since they are not given initial temperature, you need not take this. You can directly use this formula, and this formula itself is the final formula. And if at all they are given mass, after this you'll have to use this also. So right now in this problem they are given only 1 kg of mass, so you need not use this also, only this is enough. So HW, since it is a wet steam, HW is equal to HF plus X into HFG. X we found out in this, that is 0.78. HF, HFG, both we have got in the steam table. Those values I have substituted here. I got HW. Then in the second question, it is steam dry saturated. So we know that it is a dry saturated steam. In the dry saturated steam column, the formula column, in that you just have to take HG, that too from the steam table. You need not use any formulas to get this answer. Directly from the steam table, whatever the value is there, that value you have to substitute here. That is HG. Then enthalpy of superheated steam, they are given the third question. So H superheated, again, since it is a superheated steam, you refer to steam, superheated steam table, superheated steam formula table. In that, this formula is available. again, they are not given initial temperature, so you need not use this. You can only use this. That's all. This is the final answer. So H superheated is equal to this formula. Hg is available in the steam table. Cps 2.25 they are given in this. 2.25 they are given. So that value I have substituted here. T superheated, that is superheated temperature, they are given 250 degrees Celsius. So that I converted to Kelvin. And Ts is the saturation temperature that is available in the steam table. But they are given in Celsius, you convert that into Kelvin. You substitute here. And finally, you get superheated enthalpy.